Hi, I'm Toto.
Hi, I'm Sui. We haven't done some reactions for a while. Toto's here for spring break, and also we are, what are we doing?
Social distancing.
Yes, social distancing. So, what a perfect time to do some reactions, yeah? On social distancing week. The problem is, there's not some great, awesome, exciting comebacks this week. So we're kind of,
looking for stuff,
because we just want to react to something. Besides, it's kind of fun to do some random things that aren't the norm to react to, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. But there is one thing that we had talked about reacting to, and then I have talked to somebody a week or so ago on Twitter about this.
If you did not know, there is a all Filipino Kpop group.
Wait, Kpop?
Yeah.
How is that? Explain.
They're in a Korean entertainment company.
But they sing Filipino.
I think.
Or whatever that language is called.
Tagalog.
Yeah.
Although people just say Filipino.
So it's like diverse. It's a K-pop group, but they're singing their own language.
I recently re-remembered them because I actually saw them perform when I was in Korea at a festival that I went to see Uptension and Psy and GFriend. But they, SB19, was like the opening group.
And you hadn't heard of them till you saw them there.
Yeah, and I did film them. I actually put the clip on our drive if you want to watch it.
You mean like it's part of our reaction?
Well, I didn't quite get their name because, you know, everything was in Korean. I was able to understand with my Korean skills that they were from the Philippines,
yeah,
and that they were trainees. But I didn't catch their name, so I didn't know what to look up. Like a couple months ago, I think it was Jeff Benjamin posted something about them. Like,
really?
SB19 is a Filipino K-pop group, and I was like, that sounds familiar. Filipino K-pop group. And I was like, oh, maybe they're the group that's a thing. So then I stalked their Instagram and went back to May of last year when that happened, and sure enough, there was a picture of them in that thing. So I was like, yeah, that's a group that I saw. But anyway, at the time, I remember thinking I should film them in case they get really popular so then I can prove that I saw them.
See, I think they're probably not quite to the really popular stage yet, but no. People are talking about them. That's the thing.
Yeah, I saw them.
They look good. And look how freaking close you are.
I was in like the fifth row.
And you're sitting in chairs?
Yeah. Did I not tell you the process, the procedure?
I just remember that you talked about the line and all that, but I didn't realize you were sitting in chairs when you ended up there. Okay, so you saw them. There we go. That was proof. So we thought we would watch their more recent song, which is called
Alab
or Burning. Yeah, from a couple months ago.
It's got 4.5 million views.
Wow.
It's pretty good.
Yeah. All right, so here we are with SB19.
Like Alab.
Alab.
You know, I gotta get the soft A's.
I gotta sit back just a little bit.
Speaking Korean.
Yes, they are.
What do you have to do? 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 What do you have to do?
That's a cute start. Glad they have subtitles.
No, we can't stop anyway. Now the fire needs to start.
I need to listen for the words.
Alab.
Yeah. Why is that move so cute?
Just
that move. Every time any group does that move, we're always like, oh! You know me? Like, we should say who stands out to us, because I bet the people who watch our reaction will be really happy to tell us who's who and what who's and what's what. Did anybody stand out? I think these two on the end stood out a lot, but he was the cute one with braces that was frustrated with his writing, right? You're for right. You same ones,
yeah,
same ones stood out. I feel like they'd be really pretty easy to learn, huh? They're all very distinctive. All right, so people who are fans of these guys, tell us who they are. We're pausing right here on this picture. You can tell us who they are by their colors or their order.
I feel like I'm pretty familiar with, you know, Tagalog, Filipino language.
You are?
Well, what the heck? I mean, because of Inigo Pascual.
Oh, yeah, right. Say him again.
Inigo Pascual.
Yeah. And you've listened to enough that the language is a little bit familiar in his songs?
Yeah, just like the sounds and... This stuff. Dito means like now. Ikaw means you.
Yay! Good job! Okay, so what'd you think about the song and this group?
It's good.
You like it? They're cute.
Dito. Here. Not now. Here.
Alright, so people who are fans, let us know who they are, and what else maybe that would be fun to watch with
also,
them.
Also, kamusta is hello.
And that's the first one you usually learn.
Even it comes from kamusta.
And if they're really babies, just because they have braces, that might not mean that he's as baby as he
It's like Bala. Be. Bala is older than me,
but Bala is baby.
He's older than me.
Barely.
2 years.
2 years?
I don't remember.
That's fun to check out this new group. We're going to go watch some other random things. So stay tuned to see what we come up with. Let's be friends and what is this called? K-pop? What did you say, M? T-pop?
T-pop, F-pop, P-pop? What is Filipino F-pop. Pop?
Yeah, what is it? Anyway, whatever it is, we'll do that together.
I mean, it might just be Filipino pop.
We'll do that together, right? And some K-pop,
too. If any of you like Inigo Pascual, I like Inigo Pascual. Just saying.
You already said that. He's just want to make sure you get it in there.
Remember when he came to Las Vegas?
I do. He was just...
He was like an hour and a half away from me.
Oh, yeah.
And I didn't go.
Bye.
Bye.